In the signal processing field, it is very important to understand what is frequency. And this, I will show that what is frequency in by using imaging. So this project is making an image whose rows show different frequencies in increasing order, and let the size of image to be 512 by 256. That is 512 256 rows, and each rows has 512 pixels. And then we set x equal 512 and y equal 256. And let's make the first the zeroth line to be DC, so no change. So all of the 512 pixels to be 100. And then let's put first line has one cycle. So we can put like this. If we do like this, for here's the small x equal 0 to 5 11. Then if we insert small x to be 0 to 5 11 over large x. Large x is defined as 512. Then this value varies from 0 to 2 pi. So sine 0 to 2 pi becomes looks like this. So there is only one cycle for one line. And then at the second line, we make two cycle. We put two cycle by using this equation. Here, if the large x equal 512 and small x varies from 0 to 5 11, and then all of this value varies from 0 to 4 pi. So this equation makes two cycle. And then in the case line, we multiply k here, and then this value varies from 0 to 2 pi multiplied by k. So k 2 pi. So there are, if we set k equal 4, then we will have 4 cycles, like 1, 2, 3, 4. And because sine values varies from minus 1 to 1, all of these value ranges are from minus 100 to 100. Then let's make a C program to do like that. We store these values in the type of unsigned character, and the unsigned character is 8-bit value, and here unsigned means no negative value, so the value varies from 0 to 255. But here we made a value from minus 100 to 100, so before store the value, we add 100. So then the range becomes minus 100 to 100 becomes 0 to 200. So we store the value like this. And then this procedure will make an image of this size. And if okay, and we by using Photoshop we can display the image we made. Okay, let's program it. Okay, in order to make it, we need these three very simple steps. At first, we allocate memory, and then open a file and calculate the pixel values and values of each rows with different frequency, and then write in the file. And then we open a Photoshop, and then we know we can display the image. In the image, white represents high value, so 200 value becomes white, and the zero is black. And okay, let's make the program. Okay. So we don't need this. So we will make a new project. New project. And we will make a Windows 32 console program. And then we go to the class TSP folder, and we can program name is homework one frequency. Okay, and then console program, and next, and we use empty project and console program. Okay, and finish. Okay. And then we will make a program. So here is a source file, and press right button of mouse, then we add a new item. And we will add C++ file, and the name is anything, maybe Sue. Okay, no, let's make it homework one, C frequency. Okay, and add, and we include some typical header files as TEIO for file handling, and include mass .h because we will use sign function, and we include standard library for some functions. Okay, then you should write name of author here, my name, sir, and date. Today is January 25th, 13, and then we will draw an image on image file. Make an image file whose rows are different in frequency. From 0 cycle, the first line is DC to y minus 1 cycles in a row. And let's define x and y values. Define x and define y 255. Okay, and void main. And we will program in this. And the step, what we will do is like this: allocate memory, and open a file, and calculate allocate memory. I said we will use unsigned character. Unsigned character f x. Okay. Now this one should be pointer. And we allocate memory. We just allocate memory for one line. Call new unsigned character x, just for one line. So this one make memory for 512 byte. Open a file. File name could be pointer, and open, and the file name app 512 by 256 dot o, and we will write w and binary file. If program fail to open a file, then it return null. So we should make some error handling procedure here. So if it could not, then printf can't open this file. And then we should finish here. So you can put any value here. Then if the program finished here, then the program will return this value 220. So this is any value. Then let's make pixel values. So we need k and x value, and we will, the because return value of sine function is double, so we should have a double value and okay, and for and we also need to define pi here. Define pi 3. Okay, and k is rho. Rho is from 0 to y, and then k plus plus. Okay, this is k. Loop. And we will have a row x equal 0 to x equal large x and x plus plus. And we will calculate values. X call unsigned character loop and 100 multiplied by sine 2 pi k. But because k is integer, we should change it double. And k x also should be changed to be double. And divided by double. That's what we implemented for this function. Then k, we will put k from 0 to 511 and to small x from 0 to no k from 0 to 255 and x from 0 to 511. Okay. Then we calculated 512 a line. So calculate a line with frequency. Okay. Then we will write onto file. So f write to f. No. Here's this fx value to and x items and just once to onto ff file name ffx. And then we will close the file. App close. Okay. Then we push function 5, F5. Then we compile it and run it. Oh, no error. And okay. Then this file will be generated. Okay, let's see that. Open file. Yes, we have this file. This file was generated. Okay, and then this file can be shown in Photoshop. Okay, let's display in Photoshop. Okay, let's open Photoshop then. Where is Photoshop? Photoshop. It takes some time to open a Photoshop. Then file open and the format is RAW format. Where is RAW? Okay, row, and then we go to computer D class. This one, okay. This is what we generated. Okay, open. Then, oh, we should so it automatically know that the size, but normally we should put the widths and height here. So 512 and 256, and we will have 1 byte, and then 1 byte as so each pixel is 1 byte and 8 bit. Okay, then okay, this is what we have calculated. Okay, and you can see that oh, this problem, because I think the problem is I did not add 100 here, so I think this problem. Let's see. No. Okay. So I said in order to change it to unsigned character, I said we will add 100 here. Then the range of this value comes from 0 to 200. Okay, and F5 again. F5. Okay, F5. All right, and then open again. Open. Okay, open. Okay, then this is okay. Then you can see that the first line is just white line, and then the second line is has one cycle, and we will have more and more cycle, and in this last line there is 255 cycle in a row. Okay, this is image, and we will see, we can see the frequency becomes higher as increasing order. Okay, thank you.